in the name of Jesus. Lord God, let your spirit just flow, Father. Flow, overflow. Hallelujah. Flow in this place, oh my God. Hallelujah. Destroy every yoke, break every chain. Let your spirit flow. Let your anointing, Father, flow in this place. Yes, destroy the works of darkness, Lord God.
Verse 17 through 19. Verse 17 through
19, and then we also are looking at John chapter 4, verse 4. So Luke 10, starting at verse 17. The Bible says, when the 72 disciples returned, they joyfully reported to him, "Lord, even the demons obey us when we use your name." Yes, he told them, "I saw Satan fall from heaven like lightning. Look, I have given you authority over all the power of the enemy. And you can walk among snakes and scorpions and crush them. Nothing will injure you." Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to read verse 20. "But don't rejoice because evil spirits obey you. Rejoice because your names are registered in heaven." Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's look at John chapter 4, 1 John chapter 4, verse 4, the Bible says, "But you belong to God, my dear children. You have already won a victory over those people, because the spirit who lives in you is greater than the spirit who lives in the world." Hallelujah. The message entitled, "Call the Authorities." Call the Authorities. The Lord was teaching me a lesson this week, and he was showing me something that I believe that is a message for the entire church body. The Lord showed me this week that we are the people of God, and that we must take authority in this world. Now, this world is an evil, and it's a perverse, and it's a wicked world. And it was stated, well, unless the people of God start using the authority that God appropriated for us. This week I spent some time away from home. I was in a hotel. Of course, as you know, that it wasn't a church retreat, it was a work retreat. And it was a hotel, one hotel full of saints. So I was in an environment that wasn't conducive for worship. It wasn't conducive for the Spirit of God. And as I walked in, over time, you can just start to feel the spiritual forces beginning to resist you. Prayer began to get harder. You start to get weary. You don't feel like praying. Your thoughts are everywhere but on God. You just want to sit back and just vegetate and do nothing. But the Lord, thank God for his grace and mercy, he kept me in a place of prayer. Yeah. And as I began to pray, the Lord just started to minister to me that you have to take a spiritual authority, because you are in spiritual warfare. Whether you are engaged in it or not, you are in spiritual warfare. Yeah. You are in a fight. So the enemy was attacking me, trying to get me by myself. But I took authority. Through the grace of God, I took authority. And then the entire week started to shift back into the place where God wanted it to be. Things began to shift back. It began to shift back. See, and as people of God, we have that same authority. See, when we came to Christ and accepted him as our Lord and Savior, not only did he forgive us of our sins, not only did he make us righteous in his sight, but he gave us something very powerful. He gave us his nature. He gave us his spirit to take spiritual authority. See, the spiritual authority God gave us is a tool. It's a piece of equipment to use in the kingdom of God. But just like any tool, it doesn't work unless you use it in the right place. We can't look at a hammer, we can't look at a nail and wish the nail go through the wood. We, as much as that nail bothers us, it will never move unless you pick up a hammer and you do something about it. Yeah. Yeah. And as people, God, we can't just sit around and just wish circumstances change. We can't just sit around and hope things change for the better. We can't sit around and just hope we just get healed and hope we just get delivered and hope things just change in our neighborhoods and change in the climate of our homes and change the climate of our church. We can't just sit around and hope. We got to do something about it. And the tool that God given us was the spiritual authority that came directly from His Spirit. We got to change the climate. See, God gave us His authority because Jesus understood that there are spiritual forces out there that are and will always try to hinder you and the kingdom of God. This is the truth that we must all face, that there are spiritual forces at work against us. There is a such thing as demonic activity. There is a such thing as the kingdom of darkness, and it just doesn't exist metaphorically. It's just not a saying. It is real, and it's out there, and they're working against us whether you want it to or not. And if you don't take authority, they most certainly will. See, these spiritual forces I'm speaking about, they work in our circumstances, they work through people, they even work through the very nature against us. And it's real, and it's something that we must learn as the people of God on how to deal with these things. We must learn how to deal with them. The devil don't care if you say you're a Christian. The devil don't care what denomination you are. The devil don't care what church you belong to. That don't mean anything to him. His job is to kill, steal, and destroy you. That's his assignment. He is on assignment to keep you from fulfilling your purpose. He's on assignment to take you under. He's on assignment to kill you if he can. That's his assignment. And he won't stop unless you make him stop. And that's the truth. He's not going to stop doing what he's doing unless you make him stop. That's his assignment, and he's going to see it through until it's complete. He don't want you to experience life that God has planned for you. So he sets up things to hinder you, to distract you, to derail you, and ultimately, his ultimate goal is to overthrow your faith. He wants you to lose hope. He wants you to lose your desire to pursue God. He wants you to grow cold in your love relationship with the Lord. He wants you to take you as far away from the light and far away from God as he possibly can. And the further you go, the more strength he has. The further in the darkness, the more power he has over you. Now I understand that everything in this world that goes wrong is the devil, but you got to recognize when it is and know how to deal with him. You got to recognize it. And you got to deal with the devil immediately. Because that's how he does it. He comes in suddenly and just starts to work through your circumstances. He starts to work through your flesh. He starts to work on your faith. And too many times we just let it happen from the beginning, and we don't really start to try to take authority till we far gone. Till we already deep in it. Then all of a sudden we want to fight out after we've been beat up. You ever saw a boxer in a fight just taking blow after blow after blow after blow? And at some point, he had to say to himself, if I don't stop swinging back, I'm going to get punched, and he's going to eventually knock me out. Eventually, he's going to take me over. But as the people of God, we were never meant to just take the punches and then retaliate. We weren't meant to be in a retaliation comeback form. We're not people who retaliate to the enemy. See, the authority that God given us is to initiate and to engage the enemy where he is. We're the ones who push back the gates gates of hell. We're the ones who engage the enemy or overthrow him. We're the ones who throw the first punches. That's how God designed us. He wasn't designing us just to be to victim.